Throughout history, famous mathematicians made contributions known around the world. You may have heard of Isaac Newton, Albert Einstein, Euclid, and Gauss. But have you ever heard of the story of Niels Abel?
Niels Abel is such a unique and astonishing character who really changed mathematics despite living such a short life. It's him and his peers, these people, they're perfect in showing us the development of mathematics through effort. And this is why we make him our subject of investigation today.
During the early 19th century, the individual work of Niels Abel and the group work developed with his peers made revolutionary discoveries in the field of math, showing that mathematics can develop through individual and group efforts.
Niels Abel was born in Norway in 1802. He wasn't rich and grew up in poverty. His father had a spot in Norwegian politics, but only for a short time before he died early into Abel's life. When Abel was just 15 years old, he was recognized by his teacher as a mathematical genius.
Su maestro lo reconoció como un genio matemático.
Bernd Hombo, Abel's teacher, recognized Abel after seeing the immense amount of mathematical work being done at such a young age. He played a key role in getting Abel into a university, where he could study and write about math.
Well, the investment that Homeboy made, it paid off. And he raised a lot of money for Bell. Within a year, Bell obtained a degree and learned everything that the university could throw at him. And this is where he started writing his groundbreaking papers.
Abel's most famous work was what he did on quintics. In collaboration with the work of Paolo Ruffini, he created the Abel-Ruffini theorem that proves that a quintic equation was impossible. This problem had stumped mathematicians for over 250 years.
We all know what the quadratic equation is. It helps us find the roots of a quadratic or a polynomial with a degree of 2. But later on, mathematicians discovered a cubic equation to solve cubics, and then a quartic equation to solve equations with a degree of 4. But for centuries, no one could solve one of the biggest mathematical problems at the time, which is a formula for the degree of 5.
After years of work, Abel thought he had found it, and it seemed to have no errors when checked by numerous mathematicians. But when trying to apply the formula numerically, he found an error. This caused him to go on, in group collaboration with Ruffini, to develop the proof that any polynomial above the degree of 4 was impossible to solve without a formula.
The impact in developing math was instant and vast. Other mathematicians such as Évariste Galois depended on this monumental discovery. It was both an individual effort and a group effort together, and this made a difference.
Niels Abel went on to write numerous papers. One of his discoveries led to groundbreaking developments in the field of elliptical equations. Another more notable discovery was his work with integrals that paved the way for much of calculus.
Abel did a lot of work on definite integrals, integral transformations, integrals for ellipses. A lot of his work helped future mathematicians. They, as a group, built off each other and sculpted integrals and calculus as we know today. This is just another example of how groups can develop mathematics and how one individual can help so many more behind him, help them discover so much as a group.
In 1825, Niels Abel was given money to travel across Paris and Berlin to meet mathematicians who would change the course of his future. In Berlin, he met August Crell, who became his close mentor and helped publish many of Abel's works.
Creel sort of became this advisor that pushed Abel higher and higher up into the math community. And many other people did the exact same too. They all helped elevate him. And eventually, much of Abel's content could have not been done without this massive group effort from all of these people that he met in his travels. And it just goes to show that mathematics is developed strongly from this other aspect of collaborative effort. And in the case of Abel and mathematicians that he worked with, they all together helped feel just so much.
In Abel's travels to Paris, he contracted tuberculosis. Already, Abel's health declined from poverty, at times eating only one meal a day. Eventually, he returned to Norway, where he got better and spent the winter holiday with his fiancée. And at this time, he enjoyed the little love and happiness he had, and cherished his final moments with her. Not long later, he died from tuberculosis. He was just 26 years old. In the 3 short years he published papers, his individual efforts and the group efforts of those around him developed mathematics in ways that were unforeseeable. In the words of Charles Hermite, Abel has left mathematicians enough to keep them busy for 500 years.